In this video, I'm going to show you the latest modifications I've made to my Hogwarts Express 75955, released in 2018. I've got two of these and I've combined them and built them out with some extra parts and made some quite big changes. So join me as I give you a tour of what I've done. When this set came out, I was really excited for it. I could see a lot of potential in what you could do with this set and what you got in it. The train in it looks great, but let's be honest, it could be better. And that was what I wanted to try and do. So I'm going to show you in this video what I did. Now you'll notice some things really obvious, like there's two carriages and they both are longer than the normal ones. I'll talk about that one in a minute. One of them has a big wall in it, which is not what used to be there. And the eagle-eyed amongst you might notice that the train itself is a bit different to how it used to look. So I'm going to start with the train and go through that first. With the train, what I wanted to do was make it slightly closer to the actual Hogwarts Express for real. And when I looked at it, one thing I did notice was that this actually sits further back on the real one. And when you look at it a bit closer, you realise that this bit's actually longer. So all I've done is extend this by two studs. I was thinking about doing four, but I think four is going to look too much. I am missing one part here, as you can see. I will get that in my next Bricklink order. But what I've done here is this bottom bit is extended by one, and then this bodywork is extended by two. And I think it looks a lot more balanced like that one. Like that, I think it works really, really well. One thing I do want to do that I have still got to figure out is how to replace this arm here, because that's pretty basic. One thing I was actually considering was moving the wheels apart one stud each. If you look at the real train again, you'll notice the wheels are a bit more spaced out than that. This is done because it's a Lego train, that's how it works. But that's actually how it's spaced out in the real train. So I'm trying to figure out the mechanics on that one. If you've got any experience, let me know. I will listen to you and heed to your advice on that one. That would mean moving these wheels forward slightly, which I don't think is a problem. But I think that train looks a lot more balanced. The one thing that was really important to me was to keep the interior of the train, because I like the controls that you get inside there, which I'll show you quickly if you haven't seen them. You do get a fully kitted out engine room there, which is very important to me. I think that is an important feature and detail of this set. Next, the passenger car. The first thing you'll notice on this one is that it is longer than the original one by a total of six studs. This is a 24 base plate, one of the normal passenger city train base plates long. I made the decision that I wanted it to be that long. Now, I thought about going for longer steel like the Emerald Knight, but I thought I'd stick to this size because it's actually more in scale with the rest of my trains that way. If I go for longer cars, then I've got to change all of them. That's not to say I won't do that in the future though. So what I've done is I've taken a leaf out of the Emerald Knight and made the doors open, which is a very important feature for me. I think that looks really good. It's really good for setting some scenes, and I just think it adds a little bit to the train. I think it makes it look a bit better. I've gone with these for the door handles, just these 1x2 modified plates with the edge on them. I will get them in the right color. I ordered the wrong color by mistake, but I think they look fine as they are. And I've gone with the windows the same size as the default Hogwarts Express. One thing I did do though was obviously keep the lid so it opens. I've added a little bit more detail inside, but what I will show you is I made it slightly adhere to what was in the original, and that you can take these off here quite easily and then take this side panel out, as you could with the original Hogwarts Express model that this is based on. So as you can see, I haven't changed this too much. I've just put some table lamps on there. Now, one thing I am going to do here though is actually make them slightly compartmentalized and put the 1x2 by I think they're three plates that are hollow, so you can put them behind here, put them there, and then fill in this middle bit here so it actually looks like they're compartments in a train. So I think that will look quite good when it's done, and I need to get a couple of extra tiles just to fill in around this floor here. But I think just those little changes just really lift it. I did try to be a little bit clever and put a bag rack over the top, but this train is just not high enough to do it. Would have been cool to include that though. Next up, we have the dining car, which I've added. I felt that this train needed a dining car, so that's why there is a big wall here, and I'll show you the interior of that in a second. I don't know if you can quite see in there, but in there there's Dr McBrick and GJBricks having a meal, it looks like, in the dining car there. Now, I will turn this round and show you the interior of this one. Again, made the roof removable so you can see right in there. Now, I've packed in as much as I could into the space. I've reworked this a couple of times, and I will put a big shout out to JC from Small Brick City, who was the voice of reason for me a lot of times when I was building this, because he kept sort of grounding me when I went a bit too far off tangent. So we managed to come up with this design here, which I think works really, really well. So you can see that's a fully featured kitchen in there. We've got a sink, we've got some kitchen roll here, we've got a coffee machine here with the coffee brewing. There is a stove there with some stuff cooking on it. We've got the glassware and cups up here on a shelf. We've got the original treats that came with it, like the chocolate frog and some of the other treats that were on the original Hogwarts Express. You can see I've kept the other chair here and made it into a bit of a dining car. Now, it's a slightly different design. I just felt like it should be a bit different being in here, but I might change that to match the other ones. And again, I need to finish tiling the floor in there because I didn't have the parts for it. I'm really, really happy with how that looks. I think it looks great. I've even got a little shelf up here for something if I wanted to. I think it looks pretty good. I'm happy with how that looks. Now, let me know what you think, if you agree that needed to have a dining car. There's actually some shelves and some drawers down there as well. So there's a lot to pack in there. And it took me quite a few goes to make it till I was happy with it, because I was playing with some ideas. And that is not a lot of space to fit a kitchen into. So I'm happy with how that's come out. One more thing I am playing with on these cars is you'll notice they've got slightly different undersides, and I'm trying to decide what I prefer. I like this sort of detail here where it looks a bit more interesting. We've got like a relief valve, there's a pressure gauge behind it, could be some water tanks under there, things like that. So I think that's more interesting than this, which is kind of what you get on the city sets. So I think I'm actually going to upgrade my city trains to have something more like that. I just need to do a bit more research into how those look in a bit more detail. One thing as well, I made a decision on these, is that these traditional city trains, the wheels are together. I've made them spaced out like that. I think that looks better. Obviously on a longer chassis that would look better still, but I think that looks more right to me than having them two wheels jutted together. This looks less like a city toy train now and more like an actual sort of proper train, if you will. So those were my latest changes to the Hogwarts Express trains. What do you think? Do you like what I've done there? Do you agree with it? Do you think I should just put it back to how it was? You can say that I won't change it, but you can tell me if you don't agree with it. I'm happy with it. I think what I'm going to do is add another passenger car to it. So I've got the three cars. And then I did see someone who had done a brake car for the end, which is not true to the film, but I think looked really good and was slightly interesting for the rest of the build, so might do that, not sure yet. Let me know in the comments what you think of this. Do you think the build I've done here is good? Is there any other details you would add to it? If you've got any suggestions of how I can improve it. If you're new to my channel, make sure you hit the magic subscribe button and turn the bell on. I post regularly and I have lots and lots of mocks like this planned for the future. I love modifying these sets and I love building new stuff. A new train is on my list to do very, very soon. Thank you for watching, and here's a couple more videos you might like to watch now you finish this one. I'll see you soon.